Okay, so I think everybody is here, so yeah, we should get started. So, okay. I can share my PowerPoint slide. So, can you guys see the PowerPoint slide?
Yes.
Okay, so as a program for SEAD, so you have real-time webinar on country report. So yeah, these are the guidelines for this real-time webinar, but I know you well, so you don't have to change your name. So these are the title for this course, as you know, and I have to introduce the chairman of this real-time webinar. This is Yang-guk Choi, the CEO of Yok Partners. Okay. So these are the timetables for this real-time webinar. So yeah, so I think everybody is here. So as the ice breaking, we have to have time for self-introduction and the things that you expect from this training and the things that you want to do most when you're visiting South Korea. Okay, so who's gonna be the first?
Me, Hernan.
Thank you.
I wrote my presentation. Well, hi, my name is Hernan Buidret, and I am an executive of entrepreneurship and starter programs of Uruguayan National Research and Innovation Agency, ANI for the friends. My main functions are the monitoring and of financing instrument for startups, the coordination of the selection committee, and the follow-up of the financed projects for the agency. The second question, what I expect from this training is to learn new methodologies and new ways of thinking about innovation, science, technology, and culture—the culture of entrepreneurship—to apply, excuse me, this knowledge in my country. And if I go to South Korea, I want to visit the 19 technoparks, sure, and know their culture, their people, their food, and their cities. That's it.
Okay, thank you so much. So, who's next?
Ramiro, yo. Okay.
Dale vos, Germán.
Okay. Well, I am Germán Stasiniuk. I am an economist. Nowadays, I'm working on a public institution. As Hernán said before, an innovation agency. Nowadays I am coordinating the innovation equipment in the agency. I have been working there since 2015, so it's a long time. And for the training, I expect to know about the methodology of Korean Technopark, because in Uruguay we don't have this type of course. So for me it's very important to know this methodology. And what I expect if we go to Korea in the future, I would like to know the an specific technopark center, perhaps not 19, but almost one, and visit all of buildings that are inside this technopark center. It's something that in Uruguay we don't have. We have technology centers, but specifically in one topic. For example, plastic, or for example, water, but not in a not not many functions in the same center.
Okay, thank you so much. Ramiro, can you, please.
Well, good morning, or good night, or good evening to everyone. I think I'm lucky because Zoom doesn't allow you to see how thriving am I now. I'm very nervous, excuse me. Well, my name is Ramiro Roselli. I'm a chemical engineer with a postgrad in technology management. Nowadays, I'm working at the Ministry of Industry, Energy and Mining, focused on the industrial park regime. I work in the industrial policy area in the ministry. So we are working in this kind of topics at this moment. Also, I work pre-evaluating investment project related to industry and other kind of activities like tourism, services, and abroad. From this training, I would like to learn about the mistakes more than the virtues I would like to learn about mistakes, because I think mistakes is the trigger to lesson learning, and not to repeat or not to replicate things gone wrong. When I visited Korea, I think it's enough with one or two of the technoparks. I think Korea is a bigger country than Uruguay. I think Seoul it's a city. I would like to visit the antipodal city of Montevideo, Sinan. I think it's more or less 200 kilometers from the antipodal of Montevideo. But I think to know something about people, culture, football teams, why not, of Korea.
Okay, thank you so much. It's really interesting that everybody wants to visit South Korea and technoparks of South Korea. And actually, according to the Google Classroom, Ramiro, you left questions about the qualitative evaluation of a technopark. So maybe after completing your presentation of your country report and the feedback by Mr. Choi, we will have time for discuss for more for evaluation metrics. So after we have very good time as ice breaking. So let's move to the introduction of the program. I think you're very familiar to this method for progress. So the first step is the presentation and country report. And the second step is feedback on country report by Mr. Choi. And then we have time for discussion, and you can give us your questions regarding building action plan. Okay, so who will be the presenter of the country report? Okay, thank you so much. So can you share your Word file with us?
Are you seeing my screen? You asked me to share this report, no?
Right.
Well, instead of it, we made a resume. So I will try to read the resume and then try to go on this document. But I have to be watching to two different screens. We will try to talk about the resumes of the status of the economy, of the industry, and the SME in the same order that in the document. Talking about the status of the economy in Uruguay since 2017, we observe a persistent decline of GDP and persistent decline of the growth rate. Don't remember, you might remember that in Uruguay we have suffered two crises in 2002 and 2009, and every 7 or 8 years we have some kind of decline of our economic growth. Since 2017, we have a positive balance of trade. Our mainly trade is made with China, our prior client and surveyor is China. Since 2017, we observe a persistent decline of employment rate and persistent increase of unemployment rate, which is one of the principal worries of the new government who arrived at presidency in March of this year.
Pardon, Ramiro, we can interrupt for a commentary, or only Ramiro can talk. I ask you, Sofia, if we can interrupt or...
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay, in Uruguay, unemployment rate is a real problem. And nowadays, with the COVID, is one of the main problems in our economics. So the new government is taking actions to solve this problem and others that Ramiro will mention in a minute.
Very thank you. another problem is the fiscal deficit, who is about 5% of the GDP, and trying to achieve inflation targets. The rate of inflation, of annual inflation here in Uruguay, is about 10%, who is a big trouble again.
These three problems, the new government thinking plans to deal with them. The new government is work. The new government has six months the new government have been working for six months. So these are the main problems that they have to solve.
Well, excuse me, because my boss was asking me something about a future meeting. Excuse me, please.
It's okay.
A key factor for Uruguay is to improve international competitiveness. We have to improve our efficiency in the use of the resources. And we think the use of public resources is the key in order to lower the cost of the factors that affect national production. We are thinking about energy costs, and human resource costs. We have a very
in Uruguay, our costs of productions are very expensive, so it's a problem for our competitiveness. So we have to work in a more efficient way to solve these problems that are affecting now very, very much.
Thank you. Talking about the status of the industry, we have three major industries in Uruguay. The first one is the oil refinery. ANCAP is the national refinery business. We don't have resources of petroleum or oil. We import the crude oil and then we refine it in the oil refinery. It's a state-owned company. And we have at this moment two, but formal, but from the year 2022, we will have a third cellulose pulp and production mills. Two are from the Finnish UPM, and the other is from a joint venture between Arauco, who is Chilean, and Spanish, Monte Plata is a joint venture between Arauco from Chile and Stora Enso from Finland too. And then beverage concentrate mills from PepsiCo, who is located in Colonia, 200 kilometers near Montevideo. And talking about the government policies, we have two grand policies of industrial promotion. The one is called Industrial Promotion Law, who is now being tírenme letra, ¿cómo se dice? Revisando. We are now adequating the decree that regulates this law in order to try to improve the external investment rate and to make more attractive to capitals to invest in Uruguay. The decree 138 of this year is the effort that we are doing nowadays to modify the frame of the law to be more attractive, and then specifically in the terms of industrial parks and scientific and technology parks, we have an older law, and then last year we made a new law in order to include in the frame of an industrial park and other activities related to services and more soft industries. For example, in Uruguay, we are launching the Rivera Tecnoparco, the North Region Technopark, with the assessment of Korea. I remember that the master plan tells that in 2020 we are launching this project. launching on the field, no? Constructing builds and so on. This law, this new law of industrial parks and scientific and technological parks is being regulated by a decree. We have a decree, but with the new government, we are making more changes to make this frame with this regulation frame more attractive to investors from Brazil and the region, for example. In addition to these two grand policies, we have a fairly dense. Maybe some people could think that is excessive, but we have a fairly dense of law, decree, and other regulations related to specific promotion, protection, tax exemptions, subsidies, and other promotional instruments. Thinking about investment for industry, but we could remark that despite this broad list of regulations, Uruguay has a tradition to respect the legal frame of investment. One of our big weaknesses as a country is that almost 60% of our exports, are made of commodities. And this ratio has been increasing in the last years. Only 2% of our export is made of high technology manufacturers. That's a weakness to attack, I think, as a country. Well, talking about human resources in industry, we have around 500,000 workers in industrial activities, considering industrial activities, those who are described ICIC revision 4, and only 1.5% of these 500 workers are doing activities related to R&D. That I think it's very low. If you compare, for example, this data with Korea or Germany or USA and so on. And finally, talking about SMEs. Excuse me. As you can see in this image, almost 850% of our economy is made of micro businesses, micro enterprises. In Uruguay, the quantification of workers determine the size of the enterprises. In Uruguay, an enterprise with more than 100 employees, it's called or it's labeled high enterprise, no, or big enterprise, excuse me, big enterprise. Between 20 and 100 employees, we talk about a medium enterprise. Between 5 and 20, we talk about the small enterprises, and then lower than 4 employees, it's called a micro enterprise, a micro enterprise. Our economy is driven by small and medium enterprises, as you can see in the image.
Perdón, no, mira.
Right.
Meto un bocadillo. A problem that we have in Uruguay is the size of our market. So we are a small country. So for us, our size is a problem to compete with other with our neighbors, Brazil, Argentina. So for us, in our size market is a real problem, and we have to deal with this. Dale, Ramiro.
Dime. Well, the location of our small and medium enterprises, half of these enterprises are located in Montevideo, the capital city, and the rest half is located in the interior of the country. From Ani, we know that 45% of our small and medium enterprises apply international innovation policies and employs this kind of enterprises employ the 45% of the population of the workforce. Despite of having the grand majority of the enterprises, they are not so intensive. They have not so intensiveness in attracting or in employing people. Y por acá podríamos estar cerrando, ¿no, chicos?
Sí. Another difficulties of the startup ecosystems is in the market size. German talk about that. A small pipeline of high impact of and growth startups. The little development of private investment ecosystem. And the important dependence of the state for access to financing. That's it's important too.
Well, and in the index called Doing Business, no, Uruguay has shows a lack of incentives for the creation of new companies.
That's all.
Okay, thank you for your presentation. Okay, from now on, Mr. Choi will give feedback on your country report. I think it's really helpful for building action plans. So, Mr. Choi, can you do that?
Hello, my name is Yang Choi. My name is Yang Choi. I go by Choi. I have seen to you by online interview. I'd like to know on technopark analysis for this project. Do you know the Korean technopark people participating in this program?
I don't remember the names of the people. I remember that I went to the first steps of the plan. Imagine that there were there were like sensibilization activities. I know that there was an international assessment done by people from Korea and from Spain and from Colombia, and they tried to talk to us about, like I said in the beginning of my speech, they present us the model of Korea Technopark, the model of industrial polygons in Spanish, in Spain, excuse me, and the industrial parks in Colombia. And there was like a sensibilization overall about troubles, about mistakes, in order to advise us, don't do this if you want to have success in less time than we have. But I don't remember the names. Excuse me, my memory is a disaster. But I was very motivated about these topics. For example, I ended talking about Byung-Chul Han with people from Korea, for example. Not only industrial policy, philosophy, culture, discipline, Taekwondo. So maybe I'm not the best person to talk to you about this experience, because I try to absorb these soft skills more than hard skills. But this activity took place between February to November of 2099. And then in November of the last year, people from Uruguay, from UTEC, UDELAR, and UDU. UTEC is the technological university. UDELAR is the University of the Republic, a public university too. And UTU is these three universities, UDELAR, UTU, and UTEC, are the ones who are set in the place before the installation of Rivera Technopark. As you mentioned in the lectures, no, the ¿cómo se dice ancla, chicos? ¿Cómo se dice? ¿Cómo?
La base, como te veo eso.
The base to settle the Rivera Technopark was the settlement of these three universities in the city of Rivera, who is a city in the border with Brazil. So the hinterland of professionals, businesses, technological businesses, are estimated in, for example, 260,000 students who are eager to establish SMEs, to develop businesses, to make alliances or ventures with another enterprises in this region. This is the principal or the prior motive to select the location, and they made a paper to resume this kind of topics, and it is said that the project is viable. They suggest evidences to demonstrate the viability the this project to settle a technopark in Rivera.
Have we ever been to Colombia and a technopark for benchmarking in your country? Or do you have any connection with the Colombian technopark people?
No specifically.
Do you have any formally organized entities for supporting the growth of SMEs, including startups, and development of industry in your country or region?
¿Entendieron la pregunta, muchachos?
Any formally organized entity for supporting for small and medium-sized enterprise and development of industry in your country or region? Even though not technopark, a similar institution for supporting that.
Well, we have some enterprises, some accumulation of enterprises with other systems. We have an instrument called free trade zones or free zones. Some of our free zones are specialized, for example, in software development, software export to countries abroad. We have Hernán or Sherman talk about we have some technological centers or incubators, enterprise incubators that are focused on some sectors of industry. We have technological centers of plastics, water, oil, commercial oil, not petroleum. I mean, when you put a seed and press and have oil. No sé cómo decir la diferencia entre aceite comestible y bueno. We have technological centers of, me está faltando alguno. We have technological centers focused on. Repetime.
El ICB is a technological center, but in Uruguay we don't have a complex with different buildings that that you have in Korea. I was looking the different lessons and lectures that you are giving us, and is very important that in your complex you have different function as marketing and commerce service, universities, technological centers, but all of them in one place. In Uruguay, we don't have this kind of technological parts. We have specific centers, but they don't have all the connections that are required to develop a specific technological park as you have in Korea.
We have conglomerations, but we don't have clusters.
That's a key word. We don't have clusters. We have it's like the difference between the system thinking and reductionism. No? We use I think it's a culture by basis on this. In Uruguay, we try to sub-optimization of our resources. We have, for example, 10 enterprises of minery, and then we put all together, and then we extract until the last stone, and then the businesses ends for all in 15 years, for example.
I'm
building a caricature, a cartoon of the situation, but I think we are not so away from the reality.
Korea has been working in this kind of Nepal since 1995, if I am not wrong, and Uruguay started with this kind of activity 10 years ago. And I think that we don't have the patience that we have in Korea, and our development is dependent on the political partido.
Political party.
Our past depends on the person who is in the government. So we don't have a political over the years. So to develop a system that has in Korea is very difficult in this situation.
It's not yet a matter of state beyond the political party of turn.
We didn't go abroad the frame of a government policy to achieve a state policy. A government policy at least lasts for 5 years, which is the government period in this country. And in the scenario of a political party change in the government, maybe the last year you are thinking, oh, what would be of industrial policy, what would be of innovation policy, what and for people like us that are not in places of decisions, it's a bit inconsistent or make us to feel unsure or to feel uncomfortable.
Depends on the political party, the political that the industry or that the economy or whatever is more dependent on the political party than a state politics. Okay, so it's a problem to maintain in time this different action. For example, nowadays, as Ramiro said, we have a plastic center, but has 5 years, and nowadays are evaluating if we continue supporting with economical resources or not. And 5 years, if we compare with you, for example, that we have been working since 10 years ago, is 5 years is nothing. So it's difficult to project in the future models as you have in Korea.
Unfortunately, we cannot invite your party or people for learning Korean Technopark. But if possible, as you know, there are 19 Korean Technopark in Korea. Is your favorite Technopark if visiting? Are there any favorite Korean Technopark for visiting to launch your Technopark business establishment? You don't
ingeniero, usted.
¿Cuál
es el principio? ¿Qué Technopark nos gustaría conocer si tuviéramos la chance?
And
I don't know.
You don't have any information for correct Korean Technopark
No, no, we have information. I'm thinking we were reading the information, but I imagine that for us we'd like to visit a techno park that the place which are located are similar as similar to Uruguayan condition of productions or something like that. I was reading that you have 19 technoparks. If I'm not wrong, you have two in different regions that are more away from towns. Okay. So for us, if we have the possibility to go to Korea, will be important to visit a technopark that has the similar condition to Uruguayan Uruguayan locations or something like that.
And your report shows that there is a real gap between your country and Korea in industrial structure. For example, in Korea, the main industry is mainly composed of manufacturing industry, which are automobile or shipbuilding and semiconductor. But your main industry are composed of first industry, which are agriculture or natural resource. So I'd like to recommend to set or make a plan for establishment of a technopark for this gap between your country and Korea in industrial structure. Okay.
In Uruguay, agricultural is one of our main activities. So perhaps if you have a technopark that involves agricultural activities, will be fine for us. Or
manufacturing also. Manufacturing too.
Yes. Or nowadays we are exporting a lot of software as a service. So perhaps another chance is to visit a technopark center that based its activities on software development or robotics or
biotechnology. It's important to Uruguay.
Well, for example, if you talk about wood industry or forest industry or pulp industry, I think if we can see an example of multiple integration of technologies. If you talk about the woods of trees, you need a drone to collect data, image data of the situation of the plantations and the situation of the river. And then if you have an example of a technopark that at the right of a enterprise specialized in agriculture extraction, you have an enterprise that combined ensembles drones would be the excellence in examples.
I got fresh information from your report that China in Asia is most trading company to your country.
Yes.
And, yeah. I'd like to ask you at between China and Korea in trading condition or trading competitiveness, what do you think about it between China and Korea? And additionally, do you have any suggestion to have a similar technopark business model with China or Taiwan? Have we ever been to have a connection with China or Taiwan?
I don't have that information.
Maybe one difference between China and Korea is, for example, the cost of workforce. I think that in China, the people of workforce is cheaper than in Korea.
Difference of quality in production.
Maybe a transportation competitiveness is the same between China and Korea. Then is there any reason between China and your country for trading in volume? You don't know? You don't have any idea about it?
Volume of trade with China?
Yeah.
Wait, please.
Okay. And don't you think you are required to establish a new entity for supporting or balanced development in your country? Don't you think,
In 2019, we export to China $2,800 million, and we import from China 1,626 million dollars. So we have a positive trade of balance with China. With China, we trade mainly commodities. I don't know exactly which is the trade and which things we trade with Korea. I don't have this information. But with China, mainly we trade commodities. I don't know if Ramiro, no sé si Ramiro, vos tenés algún dato más de eso.
Oh, South Korea, we have data from imports from Korea about $100 million dollars, but we don't have Korea in the first 10 list of export destination. I think we import from Korea much more than we export to Korea.
The partnership with China assures us an important flow of exports.
Have we ever been to China? Have we ever been to China or Asian country?
No.
Not yet. I think Technopark is the main role for supporting small and medium-sized enterprise and development of regional industry, including strategic industry. Do you have any strategic industries that are focused on the select core or a foothold area that can be drawn on region's capability or priority? Yeah. Are there any strategic industries in the region or?
Well, if responding to the question that Sammy put in the wall, yes, Uruguay has a strategic industry that we said before as agricultural products. Well,
software development.
Yes, and nowadays the cellulosa,
cellulose palm meal, meat, soybean, and I think between these three or four products, we are talking about more than 80% of our exports in last year. I think one of our main troubles is that we should develop an industry not to export the soybean. It's better to export the oil from soybean, the food made by fermentation of soybean in another place. It's okay to export meat, but why not export meat with traceability, with value added specifications? And this is our main trouble. We have a tend to export commodities instead of trying to add value locally. I think a technopark it's an excellent way to add value locally and to export products with more added value. And about the last question, there is not a regional industry specialization strategy. 4 or 5 years ago, we studied the Euskadi model of specialization strategy applied to industries, but I think the changes in the political winds made this project to sink. We have also the assessment of Chilean government in order to try to implement industrial specialization strategy, but like I told before, it passed away 4 or 5 years ago.
For a successful technopark establishment or a business, I think it's very important to check whether your precondition for establishment technopark model in place or optimized for your strategic industry by regions. So I'd like to advise you the detailed strategic industry for core region, which included for your main industry and new cross-ending industry reflecting on the post industrial revolution paradigm. Okay. Do you have any plan to adjust by the post industrial revolution?
Repeat, please, excuse me.
A post industrial revolution, we called it the fusion of industry. There are many kinds of examples, which is manufacturing industry and IT industry, then the views to the industry is more competitive in trading condition for your country. So I'd like to recommend you to combine your main industry and the post-industrial revolution paradigm, then your country is very competitive in South America and any other world for your main industry. Right?
Well, but talking about this fourth industrial revolution, one of our main troubles is that the big companies or the world class companies are set in if you try to represent with a number, no, the grade of advance in industrial automatization, digitalization, and so on, big companies and world class companies that are set in Uruguay are in 3.5 and higher values, but our core industry, our SME company, maybe are set 1.2, because it's difficult for us to for our industry to pay, for example, a machine that has something basic like SCADA. Our machinery equipment are 40 or 45 years old. We have not equipment up to date. We don't have the state of the art in machinery and so it's automatization. It's difficult to access, for example, to subsidies and investor support for our small businesses, and we used to buy second-hand machinery. The machinery that is not used anymore in Europe or in Asia comes here, has a second life chance, for example. But this kind of equipment, I think, tops the efficiency. And well, for example, in talking about automotive, I think nowadays in South Korea is you can think about having a mechanical engine. You talk about electronical engines, electronical controls, but our mechanics, the people who arreglar chicos, ¿cómo se dice? The people who attend who repairs vehicles are qualified in the previous generation of engines. It's an example, but to try to amplify the situation.
Last comment. Broadly speaking, I know that the former president of Uruguay resigned from politics. He has been known as the world's poorest president. What's his name? The former president of Uruguay.
Tabaré Vázquez. Tabaré Vázquez, the president from 2015 to 2020. Tabaré Vázquez was the president.
At for establishing the successful technopark model specified your country, I think is important for a leading leader, like you are the former president, Buzi, Jose? I don't know.
Jose Mujica was the president of Uruguay 2010 to 2015.
Yeah. I want to be in the Jose Mujica like a presidential office or position, and three of them, all of you are playing a role for Jose Mujica, like establishing a technopark, yeah, to your country. Okay. All of you have a big play for establishing a technopark model in your country. I think so. The main important thing is human resource for adjusting a suitable technopark model in your country. The most asset in your country is human resource, yeah, for including for establishing technopark model in your country. Okay.
Well, I don't know if in Uruguay we have a human resource specific with knowledge in the implementation of technopark models. We have a very capable human resource, but I'm not sure if we have specifically human resource with the know-how to start a process like Korea did years ago. Perhaps a solution could be
I think that's why we are here.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Okay, guys, thank you for your presentation and thank you for your answers for the comment. Yeah, I think it's a really great time for all of us to building action plans. So, as I'm reflecting on comment from Mr. Choi, you can be a good leader of establishing a tech and parts in Uruguay. So please remember that, just a moment. Last Thursday, at the same time, we have a second real-time webinar. So at the time, you have to have a presentation on your action plan. So before that, you have to submit your action plan on by the 2nd November. So please remember, at the next Thursday, you have real-time webinar with Paraguay. So I will let you know the detailed information about the real-time webinar via WhatsApp.
Okay. Uruguay, Sofia.
Oh, sorry. Oh, sorry. Okay. Anyway, thank you so much again. And thank you for having you here. Yeah. It's a really good time and see you next Thursday. Bye bye.
Okay, see you. Bye bye.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you so much. You can leave this conference room.